All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about Ghost Recon Breakpoint. My name is Big Fry, and if you guys haven't heard, on March 24th, a new, what they're calling Ghost Experience, is coming to Ghost Recon Breakpoint in their new immersive mode, which is essentially trying to right every single wrong that this game did coming from their launch. Their launch was absolutely horrible. And now they're coming with this new immersive mode, which you guys are seeing on screen, the trailer that they released on the 5th of March. Realistic loot, realistic weapon swapping, being able to carry your guns through the entire campaign, no gear levels, none of the bullshit that I think every single YouTuber and even just gamer was telling Ubisoft, like, why the fuck are you guys adding this kind of stuff into a Ghost Recon experience? I'm actually happy to say Ubisoft seemingly, finally listened to the consumer. It doesn't happen that often, but this trailer and this experience is actually making me excited to play Ghost Recon, if you can fucking believe that. They go on to detail the fact that you can choose whether you want to have one gun or two, you know, primary weapons. You can choose to lose ammo on reload. So they're adding in a lot of more tactical and more realistic experiences to a Ghost Recon game. I mean, who would have thunk it? And on top of that, it's allowing you to control the amount of bandages you have, the amount of injury you're going to take, whether it's every single bullet or whatever the case. They're basically, essentially, adding mutators so we can play this game the way it was meant to be played. Now, when we say meant to be played, the way the gamers wanted this game to be designed. And they even say at the beginning, they're like, you can play the game the way it launched, or you can play the way that everybody else wanted to fuck play this game. And on top of all of that, they're allowing you to change the amount of information you have on your HUD, so you could choose a minimalistic HUD if you want to have just your objectives or your minimap, you don't want to know your ammo. All of these things should be, like, standard with tactical shooters, especially coming out of AAA studios like fucking Ubisoft. This is the most excited that I have been to play a Ghost Recon game in quite a while. Now, when it comes to Breakpoint, there's a whole bunch of shit with the drones and how you're not always fighting like human enemy AI. I still feel like Wildlands is the better of the two experiences, strictly due to that gameplay loop. Playing against drones in Breakpoint is fucking god-awful. Doing it at E3 was terrible. Playing the beta was terrible. But as most people are pointing out in the comment section, this is exactly how a Ghost Recon game should be built from the ground up. And for me, the good thing is I didn't buy the goddamn game at launch. They're having a sale right now on Uplay where you can basically pick the game up for, I think it's 67% off. And on top of that, I didn't even realize I was collecting Ubisoft points or coins or whatever, which added an additional 20% discount to the game. So I literally picked it up for like $16 American. So I'm definitely jumping back in, and I'm gonna give them props where props is due. Granted, I understand the notion of all they're doing is trying to correct the ship, right? And it's a good thing. We shouldn't be praising them for these kind of things, because we all looked and we saw that launch and we knew that they were just doing it to sell us microtransactions. And I'm glad to say that people did not buy into it. They lost their ass. And now they're trying to correct the wrongs they've did. I will give them props for it, because these are the kind of games that I play. Of course I want them to do well. And then when I saw Breakpoint, man, it was so fucking disheartening watching what they did to this franchise. This is a nice first step, and I honestly hope that Ubisoft takes this formula moving forward. Take out the regular mode. I understand you guys got to make money. You make enough money on the sales if the games are good. Okay, let's be honest. All right, these games are $60, $70, $80. You have fucking special editions. You have pre-order bonuses. You guys are making money hand over fist if you would just make the game properly. And this time you didn't, but I'm glad you're steering the ship in the right direction. We also have another issue that I want to talk about, and that's the fact that Sam Fisher is now coming back in a new DLC for Breakpoints coming out also on March 24th. At this point, I honestly don't know what to say, dude. I don't ever think that Ubisoft is going to give us a Sam Fisher, a new Splinter Cell. I don't know why. I don't know if it's because they want to make it open world and they know people are going to be pissed. So let's do like a crossover to where you're kind of playing as Sam Fisher in an open world. I don't get it. They're blue balling the shit out of every Splinter Cell fan with these. They did it in Wildlands and everyone was like, oh man, there's no way they brought Michael Ironside back just for a DLC. And then they fucking did. I'm so twisted because I don't know if I want Ubisoft to make a new Splinter Cell watching what they did to Ghost Recon, if it would be like an open world sandbox stealth game and they would try to fit in microtransit. Like, I don't know what that game would be like. I like to think that Ubisoft, after learning from the mistakes of this game, Breakpoint, maybe they would make a Splinter Cell game in the same vein as a Chaos Theory or a Pandora Tomorrow. But I don't even know if that's on the table. We're seeing fucking Prince of Persia enter For Honor. We're getting all these crossovers of games that gamers are asking for, but not getting. They're just in random DLC updates for games that we already got. Now, I'm glad that this update is coming when the immersive mode is coming, so I didn't have to skip out on a Sam Fisher DLC for a terrible game. At least we're gonna have this tactical ghost experience to play it with. But man, Ubisoft, yeah, just give us a good Splinter Cell game, man. Don't make it open world, make it linear stealth-based like Chaos Theory was, man. That's all people wanna do. The game was so good. You were doing such a disservice. And then to hear Michael Ironside's voice back again, it just breaks my fucking heart. I want, man. Ubisoft, you're fucking blueballing us and you've been doing it for years. Give us a goddamn Splinter Cell game. Guys, I am so anxious to play this ghost experience mode. I picked up the game, $17. I mean, who cares? I'm gonna jump in and I'm gonna give you guys some updated gameplay to see what this tactical immersive mode is actually like. And for those who just skipped out on it, maybe now's the time you might look. This might be the redemption arc for Ghost Recon. Maybe, just maybe. I'm being a little optimistic. I'm hoping that Ubisoft can get their shit together and turn this into a nice little redemption arc for them. And then hopefully in the next decade or so, we can get ourselves a Splinter Cell game. That would be just fantastic. My name is Big Fry. Thank you guys for watching the video. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. If you guys enjoy the videos, leave a like on them. Consider subscribing. I hope you guys are all staying safe out there, man. I know the world's crazy right now. So maybe we can take a trip to Aurora and see what all the fuss is about. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you on the next one.